The Sugar Regulatory Administration says confiscated smuggled sugar will soon be sold in government's Kadiwa stores. Jervis Malahan also reports more smuggled agricultural products were seized in a series of raids in Nabuata City.
120 million pesos worth of smuggled agricultural products have been confiscated by the Department of Agriculture Inspectorate and Enforcement Office in a series of raids in Navotas. They seized boxes of mishandled frozen pork, poultry, and fish. In a statement, DA Assistant Secretary James Layug said they will ensure the storage facilities are closed and the smugglers held accountable. Just recently, 780,000 kilos of smuggled sugar were also seized in the port of Subic. The SRA noticed that smugglers have been bringing illicit sugar when an import program is ongoing.
Sinasabi nilang technical smuggling, ginagamit nila yung permit nila twice or three times. Yung iba naman dun, just because of the confusion na ang daming asukal dumarating, baka hindi ma-notice.
The SRA also announced that the palace has approved the plan to sell smuggled sugar in Kadiwa stores.
We got a memo from Malacañang that the apprehended sugar po will be donated to the DA for sale to the public by the Kadiwa. So which is a good effort. In-auction natin, yung importer din bumibili ulit.
The agency has reclassified part of the imported sugar that arrived in the country. 60,000 metric tons of imported sugar are now in the Philippines. They are expected to reach wet market soon and will be sold at 85 pesos per kilo.
I have seen also the 105 pesos, 100 pesos in the market. Now we also have to understand na yung markets and groceries po, they keep stock. So if they bought their sugar at almost 100, pagbaba natin po ng price ng supply, hindi naman po agad-agad nila maibaba yon.
The DA said the closure of the Central Azucarera de Don Pedro in Batangas will not dent the current supply of sugar in the country. Sugar workers recently protested at the DA Central Office as truckloads of sugarcane remain unmilled.
Paano ang gagawin doon sa mga planters na hindi na mill yung kanilang pong mga canes, ano? At hindi lang ito maliit, malaki rin ito pag kinonsolidate mo. There was a proposal before na dalhin dun sa Tarlac, no? But baka masyadong malaki ang gastos, pero gagastusan naman daw po yun ng government, which is the Sugar Regulatory Administration. Ang mahirap ko pagtag-ulan, I'm sure mag-deteriorate din yan. So dapat ang gawin ng Sugar Regulatory Administration, dapat immediate yung action nila kung anong gawin na alternative dun sa pag-mill nitong canes ng ating mga sugar planters.
Price of other commodities like rice and fish are stable as of Monday. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
A former soldier turns himself in after he was tagged as one of the suspects in the assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel De Gamo. The Justice Secretary believes this suspect has vital information that can help solve the crime. We have this report.
Another suspect in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel De Gamo surrenders to authorities. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the suspect, a former soldier, can provide them with critical information that will help solve the case.
Yung mga sinasabi niya, number one, corroborates previous statements made given to us. And number two, he knows the other people who were involved. Kaya alam natin ang yung extent ng network. Kaya marami pa kaming persons of interest na hinahanap.
Remulla adds, authorities still cannot say for sure the exact participation of embattled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. in the crime.
Naming as mastermind or participation or role in the crime. Well, what I can tell you is that there are circumstances which lead you to the conclusion that he was perhaps involved in the crime. But the specifics of that, we cannot tell you as of now.
Interior Secretary Benjamin Abalos Jr., who heads Task Force De Gamo, said the suspect surrendered to the armed forces of the Philippines.
we welcome the report of the surrender of at least of one other suspect who is now under the custody of the AFP. We understand that the suspect has vital and critical information that we hope will pave for the resolution of this case the soonest possible time.
The AFP says the former soldier who surrendered on Friday in Negros Oriental had the rank of sergeant. He was dismissed in 2016 after he was linked to illegal drugs.
Sa ngayon, ngayong umaga lang, we turned him over sa NBI. At siguro, after getting the statements and we're able to validate kung ano yung mga sinabi niya, nasabi nga nagtugma din sa mga nasabi ng mga those earlier arrested. So hanggang doon lang muna.
Remulla said the DOJ also plans to replace prosecutors in Negros Oriental handling the Degamo Slay case to remove possible allegations of bias.
Philippine lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr., who has been linked to the death of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo, is given a Tuesday deadline by his colleagues to appear before an ethics panel probe on his unauthorized stay overseas. RG Cruz reports.
After a closed-door meeting that lasted more than 2 hours, the House Ethics Committee gave Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr. until 5 o'clock of Tuesday afternoon to physically show up at the Batasan Pamansa, or the committee will recommend sanctions. The panel continued to tackle its motu proprio investigation on the lawmaker's continued absence from the country as his travel authority expired March 9. The panel rejected the lawmaker's bid to face the panel via teleconferencing. The panel wrote Congressman Arnolfo Teves through its chair last March 15 to get his explanation on his continued absence. House Ethics Committee Chair Coopnatco Partidist Representative Filimon Espares was tight-lipped on what the panel discussed except for the ultimatum.
We give another chance of 24 hours for him to really personally appear in our committee. Otherwise, the action of the committee will be based on his non-appearance. But then, once he will appear before our meeting tomorrow, might be our decision of the committee has nothing to do now with regards to disciplinary action, given that he appeared before that deadline.
But the lawmaker's legal counsel, Ferdinand Topacio, flagged the House for requiring physical presence when the House rules even allow voting in the House through electronic channels. Topacio appealed to lawmakers to consider his client's safety.
If you just want to really and sincerely hear the side of Congressman Teves, anong problema kung hindi personal appearance? Anong problema kung video teleconferencing? What part of grave and serious threats do they not understand? Hindi pa nga nag-umpisa investigasyon ganito na ang trato sa kanya.
Topacio showed media proof that the panel and the office of the Speaker, Martin Romualdez, received his camp's written explanation, where it was clarified that the Speaker did not order but merely requested that the lawmaker come home. So clearly, no orders were disobeyed. Topacio also rejected calls to freeze his client's assets and to expel him from the lower house, insisting that his client enjoys presumption of innocence till proven otherwise. Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, the widow of slain Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo, earlier appealed to Congress to dismiss Teves as a member of the House of Representatives.
Meron po tayong procedure for expulsion at may grounds for expulsion. Hindi po basta-basta in-expel ang isang miyembro ng Kamara. Bakit po? Not only because of the presumption of innocence, but because kapag basta-basta nyo in-expel ang isang miyembro ng Kamara, you disenfranchise the district which that congressman is representing. Mawawala po ng representasyon ang ilang daang libong tao sa Kongreso. Lalong-lalo na, suspect pa lang, hindi pa nga suspect eh. Wala pa nagtuturo sa kanya eh.
The ethics chief was careful in addressing questions on what awaits their colleague should he fail to show up. The Constitution empowers the House to discipline its members, but a two-thirds vote is required for expulsion and suspension, and suspensions cannot be over 60 days. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.